Our great Lord Sri Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, chapter 15, verse 5, that we should have certain qualities so that it enables us to reach the highest goal of liberation. Liberation is a state of extreme peace and freedom. If we are free from vanity and delusion, if our desires are completely stilled, if we are free from the dualities of pleasure and pain, only then can we reach the liberated stage. In this video, we shall explore the concept of mundane attachment that prevents us from getting liberated. We start identifying with everything around us right from childhood. We get identified with our name given to us by parents and also with our form that we see in the mirror. This is the beginning of Maya in our life. This is a stage of false identification. This identification increases in degree and variety as we begin to age. Thus, we distance ourselves from our essential nature, which is the spirit. A devotee, on the other hand, is an individual who has undergone a severe reversal of body identification compared to the common man. It is not possible for us to let go of our identification through a simple decision. This process of disengagement is the subject matter of sadhana bhakti. In the course of spiritual discipline, the devotee trains to attach himself with the Supreme Spirit and through this process learns to disengage from worldly entities. This process is not easy as it seems to be. The devotee has to first realize within his heart that other than the Supreme Spirit, nothing belongs to him and he deserves nothing of this world. This view is not a psychological suggestion that we should give to ourselves, achieved through auto-suggestion or any other Western practices. The Western practices are outright rejected since spirituality does not fall under the purview of psychological or mental speculation. A person considered expert in psychology can never understand topics directly related to spirit. Only through sadhana we can become eligible for grace. Once grace is attained, we graduate out of the psychological games that the world and the mind plays. Once we are placed in the field of perfect spiritual knowledge, free from any psychological inducements, we develop one-pointedness towards the Supreme Being, the source of creation. If we dedicate ourselves to God, we become utterly disinclined towards the world and worldly activities, which are mere manipulations of the psychological phenomenon. Once we become disinclined towards the world, we become interested in God to the exclusion of all other interests. This is the process of bhakti which the Shastra puts at the topmost shelf in the rack of spiritual practices. Attachment to God is called Rati and the dispassion towards the world resulting thereby is called Vairagya. By taking refuge under God, we become free of all materialistic emotions because what existed as materialistic emotions get transformed into love for God or bhakti. This is the spiritual practice of the highest order. Objective of devotion is to become immersed in God by serving Him through thought, word and deed. Remembering the Lord at all times is the hallmark of devotional practice. Only when devotion grows in the heart can attachment to the body be cut off. All worldly actions are born out of the fundamental misunderstanding that the body and mind is the self. When this misunderstanding is defeated, we are awakened to the original self. All desires relating to the world then comes to an end and the world loses all attraction. The mind belongs to the world when it is not purified. The world is transient and so is the mind. Just as newer things start cropping up in the world and older things start to vanish, the mind too starts nurturing desires. With time, the mind starts clinging from one desire to another like a dissatisfied monkey. The body ages and starts becoming weak, but the mind continues its madness like a busy ghost and never lets peace descend upon the heart. This is the nature of desires. Even if an object is attained by the mind, it is unable to enjoy the same object for a long time. The interest levels fall and the mind looks for a change. The endless process keeps the mind in constant agitation. The more one tries to satisfy desire, the more the mind shall continue agitation. Trying to satisfy desire is like trying to extinguish the fire with clarified butter or ghee. So, a striver has to become conscious of the mind's workings and pull away from those things which the mind desires and instead cultivate the habit of desiring the Lord. Except the Lord, nothing else has the capacity to put the mind to rest. We find a similar discussion in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 11, Chapter 3.